This is PrusaSlicer, our own in-house developed slicer with features like variable layer height, custom supports, or modifier meshes. And today we're gonna go over all of the new features and improvements that we introduce in the version 2.0. First of all, this update is so huge that we thought it's the perfect time to rename Slicer Prusa Edition, or Slicer PE, to Prusa Slicer. Why? Well, the main reason is that the old name was really confusing. Even in our own materials, we often didn't include the PE suffix, and the community used Slicer and Slicer PE pretty much interchangeably. The first thing that you'll notice has changed is the user interface. Slicer was always known to be powerful and versatile, but some features were difficult to use, if not outright hidden behind some obscure menus and dialogues. Our goal with the reworked UI was to expose all of the power features, while at the same time making the UI clear and simple to use. To lower the learning curve for beginners, we introduced the simple mode. Here, the user interface resembles the UI of Prusa Control. Complex features like modifier meshes are hidden, and only a basic subset of parameters is shown. In the advanced mode, more parameters are shown, and in the expert mode, all of the power features of Slicer are accessible. To make learning of the parameters easier, we color-coded them. Green parameters are safe to be tinkered even by a beginner. Yellow are for advanced users, and red are expert settings, most of which should only be touched if you're making a profile for a new printer. Both the top and left toolbars have been reworked. We've redrawn all of the icons and implemented support for vector icons. So moving forward, all icons will be in vector, having essentially infinite resolution. All of the tools in the toolbar also got handy shortcuts. You can display them by going to Help, Keyboard Shortcuts, or by pressing Shift question mark. For comparison, this is how the toolbar looked before, and this is how it looks now. Also, you may have noticed that Prusa Slicer now displays print bed models with textures. Do you remember how double-clicking on a model opened up a whole new window with 3D preview, in which you could add modifier meshes, cut a model in half, or change specific settings? Well, this whole window is now gone, and these changes can now be done directly in the 3D view. The cut tool is a great example. Select the model and press the C key, or click on the cut icon. You can now drag the cut plane up and down, or you can enter an exact value in the cut window. We added new object manipulation gizmos for translation, rotation, and scaling along all three axes. When you use the rotation gizmo, it snaps to the inner ticks spaced 45 degrees apart, and to the outer ticks spaced at 5 degrees. Everywhere else, it's free rotation. You can scale the object uniformly by grabbing any of the corner boxes or along any of the three axes. Instead of using the gizmos, you can write exact values in the object manipulation panel. What's really handy is that when you click on any of the text boxes, an arrow will show you which axis is being affected in the 3D view. You can choose to view the object manipulation values in either world or local coordinate system. And multiple objects can now be selected by holding down the control key. And they can all be manipulated as a group, so you can rotate or scale them all together. The object list in the right sidebar now displays a hierarchy of objects, their instances, objects parameters, and modifier meshes. This way, you can quickly get a clear idea of the project structure and what settings were changed for specific models. We hide this panel in the simple mode, so switch to advanced or expert modes if you want to use it. An exclamation mark is shown in the object list next to a model containing errors, like gaps, cracks, or intersecting triangles. If you're on Windows 10, you can click on the exclamation mark, and Slicer will send the model to the NetFab repair service. A model instance can now be set as a separate object through the right-click context menu, or by simply drag and dropping it away from the parent object. Breaking the link between the parent and the instance lets you, for example, change the scale of the copy while keeping the original object unaffected. And new instances can now also be created by simple copy and paste. Slicer has always been rather generous with supports, which is good. If you use the auto-generated supports, your model will surely be printable. But with some models, the algorithm may place them in hard-to-reach places or in spots where they are not really necessary. The model context menu, that's when you right-click on a model, now lets you create support blockers and enforcers. Support blockers are useful when you're generally happy with the automatic supports and you simply want to exclude some areas from support generation. Support enforcers work the opposite way. First, you turn automatic supports off, and then you select specific parts of your model which will need supports. The color print feature has been integrated directly into PrusaSlicer. When you're in the layer preview, you can move the slider, and then you can click on the orange plus icon to add a color change. The preview is displayed instantly, so you'll see exactly how your model will look with the color change. And you can remove the color change by clicking on the gray cross icon. The file menu now has the option to save project, which creates a FreeMA file containing all objects, settings, color changes, modifiers and its parameters. It's essentially a complete snapshot of PrusaSlicer. If you open the project file on a different computer, it should still produce the exact same G-code. And by the way, using FreeMA files is the preferred way of sharing model files on our community website prusaprinters.org. With the release of our original Prusa SL1 resin 3D printer, we added masked SLA mode into PrusaSlicer. This would deserve its own video, but to keep things short, in the configuration wizard, you can add the SL1. If you then switch to it in the printer settings, the UI will change to SLA mode. Here you can generate automatic tree supports or manually edit and add new supports. We have tons of ready-to-print resin profiles and you can customize or create your own in the material settings tab. Finally, you can preview the rasterized layers and export the print file. There are many other new or improved features, so let's quickly go over some of them in no particular order. We have support for high DPI, so the scaling now works properly even on high resolution displays. The print time and material use estimate is now calculated in the preview before exporting G-code. Background processing now works really well. It's only reslicing anything that has been changed by the user. Assigning colors for the multi-material is now much easier. You can now assign different infills for top and bottom layers. We have an upload queue for the octoprint, so it no longer blocks the user interface. There are shortcut buttons next to the profile selection boxes, so you can quickly jump to, for example, print settings. And we now support the octoprint cancel object plugin. Now, there are many more features coming. Undo and redo are on the top of our to-do list, but that's for the next version. Happy printing!